Interestingly, they primarily swim in huge, huge groups. They have this period when they swim and eat. The sun you see flying off of them, that's their poop, because they scrape algae and other vegetation off the reefs, but some coral particles also get in. They poop out in a day, up to 250 grams of sand, and in a year up to 90 kilograms on average. These are the biggest contributors to that beautiful white sand you see on tropical beaches, all thanks to...
Also interesting, they gather in these groups precisely by size, not by any other principles, just by the size of the fish.
Well, yes, the adults swim. Also interesting, when they swim and nibble on the corals, it makes such a sound that even underwater, many, many meters away, you can hear it. So you can hear a crunch, 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 look around and see that the school of parrotfish is swimming.
Also, I know that their teeth grow throughout their lives. Another interesting feature of these fish is that they lay eggs directly into the water, and it just floats in the water and becomes part of the plankton. Then it settles on the coral reef itself, and it stays there until the little pirate fish start hatching. The largest pirate fish are the humphead pirate fish, with a large hump on the head, growing to 1.3 meters in length.
We often met them here, but they usually swim in smaller groups. However, on Wayag, we did meet such large groups. Actually, this type of fish is very important for coral reefs all over the world.